I think last time in the group we were discussing about those last the two homework questions. I want to just clarify. Okay, some of you had little doubt in writing it properly. So home exercise question number 1 and 2. I want to just discuss with you. Before I tell you the answer, just answer this question. Just revision we will do. So imagine something is moving with some velocity v. Okay, this is the velocity. Magnitude is called speed. So magnitude of velocity is called speed. So when I say I am running with 10 meter per second, 10 meter per second is the speed. If I tell you the direction also, then it is called velocity. Now look carefully. Suppose I apply acceleration in the same direction, then the speed will increase or decrease in the same direction. Then the speed will increase or decrease. Speed will increase. Matlab, it will move faster. So the speed will increase. Speed will increase. Okay. Suppose the body is moving with some speed like this, and I apply acceleration in the opposite direction. Suppose acceleration is in opposite direction, then it will slow down. Then it will slow down. Slow down matlab what? Slow down. See, slow down has nothing to do with direction. Slow down means speed is decreasing. Speed. So speed will decrease. Now think, okay? Think without, don't be very hurry in answering. Suppose the body's velocity is in this direction. Okay, this is first case, second case, and suppose acceleration is acting in this direction. It can act. It can act in any direction. My question is, can I say it will move faster or slower now? Can I say the speed will increase or decrease? So now I cannot say it will move faster or slower. I cannot say, because this is neither in the same direction nor it is in opposite direction. But since there is acceleration, something it should do, no? Some change in velocity should happen. So we can, one thing is clear, speed cannot increase. Matlab, neither it can move faster nor it can move slower. However, what has to change? Velocity has to change because there is acceleration. If there is acceleration, velocity has to change. So direction will change. So what will happen is the body will move somewhere here. Okay, but speed will be same. So please remember, even if speed is constant, even if speed is constant, if velocity is changing, it is possible for speed to be constant but velocity to change. Why? Because velocity is vector. Velocity has magnitude also, direction also. So even if the magnitude is constant, 10 meter per second, 10 meter per second. So number is constant, but direction is not constant. So in that case, there will be acceleration. Okay. So please remember this part also. So what this acceleration will do? It will change direction. It will change direction of velocity. It will change direction of velocity, but it cannot change what of velocity? It cannot change what of velocity? Magnitude of velocity it cannot change. So in question number 1 home exercise, it was mentioned if a body is neither speeding up or slowing down. Now this word speeding up and slowing down, it has to do with magnitude of velocity. So neither the magnitude is increasing nor the magnitude is decreasing. 10 meter per second, 10 meter per second, 10 meter per second, 10 meter per second all the time. Can I say, does it mean there is zero acceleration? No, because who knows, the direction may be changing. The direction may be changing even if the magnitude may not change. So even if direction is changing, then you need acceleration. you need acceleration. So you cannot say acceleration is zero. So when can I say acceleration is zero? When velocity is constant. Only if they say speed is constant. No, I did not understand your question. Is in constant means what? Is in constant. So when will I say acceleration is zero? Acceleration is zero when velocity vector is constant. Velocity is constant. Okay, so I think first you have to understand the meaning of velocity and speed. So velocity is a vector quantity. It has magnitude as well as direction and direction. Okay, speed has only magnitude. So in this example, can I say velocity is constant? Abhigna, now how it is? Hi na, okay. So let's hope it stays like this. Fine. So that was the first answer. Okay. Now in the second question, question number two, home exercise, they gave you a graph like this. First of all, you have to see it is XT graph or VT graph. What graph it is? Check once. It is XT graph. So XT graph means displacement time graph. So graph is XT. Once you know graph is XT, what is the slope? Slope is velocity or acceleration? Slope is velocity. So that is the first thing to remember. So it is a XT graph, slope is velocity, and it is one dimensional motion. How I know it is one dimensional? Because only X coordinate they have shown. So only X coordinate is changing. If it is three dimensional, they have to show three graphs for X coordinate also, Y coordinate also, Z coordinate also with time, with time. So this is a one dimensional problem, one dimensional problem. And it is XT graph. So since it is XT graph, you know the slope of XT graph is velocity. Correct? Now, what kind of graph they have given? The graph is something like this, and it is like this. Up to some time t naught. Right? Now check in this time, what is the slope? It is a straight line. So slope is constant or not constant? In this part, you can see the angle is constant. So since the angle is constant in this part, the slope is constant. So up to time t naught, slope of this graph, which is nothing but velocity, is constant. Okay, so up to this much time, you can see the angle is constant. Whether you talk about this time or this time or this time, it doesn't matter. If you draw tangent anywhere, the angle is constant. So slope will be constant, velocity will be constant up to this time. After t naught, after time t naught, what is the slope? It is like this line. So what is the slope? Zero. So slope zero means velocity is zero. Velocity zero means it came to rest. So basically what this example means is something is moving with constant velocity and then suddenly it stopped. So that is the answer you should write. No, this is the answer you should write. Now, can anybody tell me, is such a graph possible in our real life? In real life, is it possible for this situation to happen where something is moving with constant velocity up to this time? 10 meter per second, and then suddenly after this it has stopped. Suddenly velocity has become zero. Is it possible? It is impossible. Okay, it is impossible. Why it is impossible? Because at this point, at this time, listen carefully, don't write anything right now. Listen carefully first. At this time, listen carefully, I told Tarun. At this time, just before you see, velocity was constant. Constant means some number, 10 meter per second. After that, suddenly it became zero. Suddenly velocity cannot become zero. Suddenly, at one moment, velocity cannot be zero. It will always take some time. That is why the formula is what? A equals to V minus U by T. Right? So if I rearrange, V will be equal to U plus AT. Rearrange this formula. So in order for U to become V, in order for initial velocity to become final velocity, it must take some time. That property is called inertia, but I don't want to teach right now. That we will study Newton's law. So right, like this graph is not possible in nature. Actually, how the graph should look? The graph should look something like this. This is fine. This is possible because here you can see the slope is slowly changing and becoming zero. Can you see or not, students? Here, if you draw tangent at different points, you can see slowly the velocity has become zero. Gradually, the slope has become zero. But here, suddenly it has become zero. See, it was constant slope. Suddenly it became zero. So 10 meter per second, suddenly zero. That suddenly zero is impossible unless you apply infinite acceleration. If your acceleration is infinite, listen, if I cross multiply, can I write like this or not? If I cross multiply, yes or no? Now you answer. Now you tell me, if acceleration is infinity, something divided by infinity is zero. If you take one apple and divide by infinity, what will you get? No apples you will get. You will get apple juice. So if acceleration is infinite, then your time taken will be zero. Time taken for velocity to change. So please remember, in real life, acceleration will never be infinite. Therefore, it will always take time for velocity to change. So the real graphs will look like this, not like this. But this is hypothetical question. Hypothetical means we have just created out of our own fantasy. It's not real, but everybody understood? Somebody asked a question. Long question it was. Sir, I have a doubt. When particle is at rest, velocity is zero in XT graph. What XT graph, why you are saying velocity is zero? That's it. What is its acceleration? No acceleration. No, if velocity is always zero. Neha, first of all, Neha, put your question in the group so that everybody will know what I am saying. Otherwise, they will think I am answering to nobody. What is its acceleration on VT graph? See, if velocity is zero all the time, acceleration will be zero. So right now, that question we will discuss later when we get such questions, not now. Okay. Look here. This is your XT graph.
If particle is at rest, Neha is asking this question. Let me answer her. If particle is at rest, at rest, okay, completely at rest, then what is velocity? Zero. If velocity is zero, how will the slope look? How will the graph look like this? Yes or no? This you agree, everybody? We have drawn this graph before also. This is how it will look, right? Okay. Now she is asking, how will VT graph look? Is it the question? Neha, are you asking this question, right? How VT graph will look? Let me ask Neha. Neha, are you there? Huh. Then bro, see, velocity is zero. Your graph will be here. Like this. Huh. It will be merged with x-axis. Correct. I have done this, I think. First question was this only, I think. Okay. Yesterday, first question was this only. Okay. Fine, students. See, students, home exercise, you people should try to solve correctly. If I do learning exercise also, home exercise also, when will be complete syllabus? Okay. Question number 10, I think today we have to do. Listen to the question carefully now. Figure below gives XT plot. XT plot means, again, displacement time graph of a particle in one dimensional motion. Three different small intervals of time, equal intervals of time, are shown in the graph. In which interval the average speed they are saying is greatest. Speed matlab, again, only magnitude. And in which one it is least. Give the sign of the velocity also they want, sign of the velocity. Also mention the number of times the velocity becomes zero. So let us plot the graph. This is x, this is t. I will try to draw the exact graph. Okay, something like this it is, right? Now they have shown you three small intervals of time, very small intervals. Okay, so first interval is here. This is interval 1. Second interval is here. And third interval is here. So we need to know in which interval first the speed is maximum. Speed, because they are asking about speed, average speed here. But since the interval is very small, you can consider it as instantaneous also, no problem. Now look carefully. This is XT graph. So slope of XT graph, you know, is velocity. Slope of XT graph is velocity. And magnitude of the slope will give you the magnitude of the velocity. And that is nothing but your speed. Okay, so let us see where is the slope maximum. Last class also I told, to know the slope, you just have to draw a tangent and check whether the tangent is more vertical or more horizontal. So let us draw. Here they want, in this interval. So let me draw one tangent here like this, one tangent here like this, one tangent here like this. Correct, huh? So in which portion the tangent is most vertical? In 3. Right, it is most vertical. So since slope magnitude is maximum at 3, therefore speed is maximum at 3. So it is greatest matlab maximum. So to know the speed, you just have to check in which part the tangent is making maximum, you know, it is most vertical. The most vertical one will have the most slope, and whichever will have more slope will have more velocity. And since we want speed right now, we need to talk only about magnitude. No need to talk about which is minus, which is plus. Yesterday also I have explained. So first part is clear or not clear? Anybody who has doubt, ask me now only. So just try to draw tangent here, tangent here, tangent here, tangent here. then check in which tangent is most vertical, that will have maximum slope in magnitude. Everybody understood the first part? Okay, now second part, what they are asking, in which one it is least? Now where is the slope least? This is least, see, it is almost zero angle.
So since magnitude of slope is minimum at 2, therefore speed is minimum at 2.
Okay, at 2. Then they are also asking, give the sign of the velocity for each interval. Sign of the velocity. Now we have to talk about sign. To know the sign, what I told, acute angle means positive velocity, obtuse angle means negative velocity, right?
So here it is acute, here it is zero only, so here I cannot tell. So at 3, velocity is positive. At 2, I cannot tell the sign, it is almost, it is horizontal only. And at 3, velocity is what? Positive or negative here? Ah, this is 1, sorry, at 1. This is 1, no? So at 1, it is acute angle. This is acute angle. This is obtuse angle. So at 3, velocity is negative.
But again, negative only means the body is moving in opposite direction. Remember, magnitude will be more only here. So this may be plus 2 meter per second. This is minus 10 meter per second. Which is moving faster? Plus 2 meter per second or minus 10 meter per second? Which is moving faster? Plus 2 or minus 10? Because the minus is only to tell it is moving in opposite direction. But the person is still moving 10 meter per second. No. Minus means what? Direction only.
Then finally in part D, they have asked,
also mention the number of times velocity becomes zero. Velocity will become zero whenever it will turn, remember, turn.
So wherever the slope, here it is zero, here it is zero. Let me draw the graph separately once more, okay? So this is your XT graph. Your graph looks something like this, right? So you can see at this point, which was 2, and this point, let me write 4. At this point and this point, wherever it is maximum and minimum, if you draw the tangent, it will be parallel to x-axis, right? So therefore, it is 0 here, it is 0 here. So at 2 and 4, 4 I have to write myself, okay? In the question, they have not mentioned 4. Velocity will be 0. So there are two times when velocity will be 0. One time is this, one time is this. This time.
Huh, two times, no? Two times you write, no, that's it. But for you people to understand, I have to mention, no, where it is zero. For you people to understand, I have to write, no, where it is zero. Here it is zero, here it is zero. So just draw the tangent, that's it. Just draw the tangent and check where it is parallel, where it is like this. Wherever the tangent will be parallel to your time axis, your velocity at that moment will be zero. That is instantaneous velocity, remember. Okay. Okay, just answer this question once.
This is x, this is t. Graph is looking like this.
Tell me how many times velocity becomes zero. Velocity, okay, not x. How many times velocity? Everybody has to answer. Where is Channa today?
Channa, are you in class or some? Channa is not there today in the class. Huh? Okay. Four times it is zero, right? Where it is zero, you can check. Here is slope will be zero. Here slope will be zero. Here slope will be zero. Here slope will be zero. So instantaneous velocity will be zero four times. Here, here, here. Here it is positive. You can see acute angle positive. Here it is negative. Here it is negative. Here it is positive. Here it is positive. Here it is negative. Here it is negative. Here it is positive. Now starting point you can check. No, it is like this. Tangent is like this. Who told about starting point? I started the graph like this. Yes or no? So at the start, if you draw tangent, it will be like this. So that tangent is not parallel to x-axis, correct or not? If I started like this, if I start like this, then yes, at the starting point, velocity will be what? Others try to answer. It will be zero because the graph is going like this. So if you draw tangent here, it will be parallel to x-axis. Okay. Let us do the last question of this. After this, we are going to do something very important for your board exams and for your entrance exam, for both exams. Okay, so please stay in the class for the whole duration. Figure gives speed time graph. Okay, this time they have given you speed time graph. Okay, of a particle in motion along a constant direction. So direction is constant, but speed is changing. Let me draw the graph first. Something like this. Okay. So here A they are writing, here B, here C, here D. And here one interval is there. Here one interval is there, two. Here one interval is there, three. So this time they have given you VT graph, remember, if you see the graph. First question is, in which interval is the acceleration greatest in magnitude? Only magnitude, don't worry about the sign right now. Sign, you don't worry. So first we have to talk about what is speed of VT graph. What is speed of VT graph? Speed of velocity. See, here it doesn't matter because direction is constant. So only speed is changing. So even velocity will change. So acceleration. So in which interval, 1, 2, or 3, they are asking your acceleration is maximum in magnitude only. Okay. So you know that acceleration is slope. And you know how to find slope. Draw one tangent here, and draw one tangent here. Which tangent looks most vertical? Which tangent looks most vertical? 1, 2, or 3? 1, 2, or 3? 2, right? So at 2, the slope, again, magnitude. It may be negative, but I don't care about the negative sign right now. At 2, the slope is, which is acceleration, is maximum. Okay. Then what they are asking next? Choosing the positive direction as the constant direction of motion, give the signs of velocity and acceleration in the three intervals. First one, okay. So they want the sign of velocity. Now velocity is positive everywhere because this is velocity and we are drawing the graph this way. Excuse me, for velocity don't find the slope of this. Students, do we need to find slope of this to find velocity? Slope of this is velocity, yeah. Slope of this is not velocity, students. This is velocity now. So every point you just go this side. this side. Okay, so that is velocity. So velocity is positive everywhere. Velocity is positive everywhere because the graph is this side, not this side. Now the next question is acceleration. What is the sign of acceleration? Now at 1, the slope, if I make the slope tangent, it is acute angle. Acute angle means acceleration will be positive. Okay, at 1, semicolon, at 2, what will be acceleration? Positive or negative here? If I draw tangent, it will be negative because the angle is obtuse with this axis. Okay, and here so it is zero only. At 3, acceleration is zero. Why acceleration is zero here? Because slope is zero. Okay, so be careful what you have learned from these two questions. First we have to check which graph is given. First we have to check which graph is given. Question number, what are they asking next? What are the acceleration at points A, B, C, D? That you tell everyone. At points A, B, C, D, what is the acceleration? Draw tangent here at A, it is horizontal only almost. B, C, D. So acceleration is zero since slope is zero. Okay. So we have completed this. Now they can always make one of them as your MCQ. Yes or no? This kind of questions. One, like they may give you this graph and they may ask at which points acceleration is zero, like A, B, C, all of them. So answer will be all of them, A, B, C, D. They may ask where is your acceleration negative. They may ask where is your acceleration negative. 1, 2, 3 or somewhere 4 like that, or maybe here 4, wherever. So 4 options you can tick, right? So the point is you have to learn how to find sign of velocity and sign of acceleration from XT graph and BT graph respectively. So to find the sign is very, very easy, students. Just draw one tangent and check whether the angle is acute or obtuse. And I'm not forcing you to remember that. I have already done, if you remember last class and before that, when I was teaching you differentiation, I have already explained to you that rate of change is always given by slope. And velocity is nothing but rate of change of displacement with respect to time. So slope of displacement time graph will be velocity. Yeah. Everybody understood these concepts? Okay, so now try one simple question. Okay. So I've given you velocity time graph. You have to tell me acceleration at t equal to 1 second and acceleration at t equal to, let's say, 4 seconds. So at t equal to 1 second, you have to tell me the acceleration, and t equal to 4 seconds, you have to tell me the acceleration. Try once. You know this is what graph? VT graph. extra, okay? So how do I find acceleration? First, what I should know, slope of VT graph, slope of VT graph is acceleration. First thing I should know is slope of VT graph is acceleration. Then at what point they want? T equal to 1 second. T equal to 1 second means somewhere here. So there, if you go like this, if you draw a tangent, then whatever angle this angle theta, that will be your slope, tan theta. This part everybody understood how to find slope mathematically. I told wherever you want the acceleration or slope, you have to draw a tangent. Since the line is straight, tangent will be that line only. Now this theta will be same as this theta. This theta will be same as this theta, correct? So how can I find tan theta now from the diagram? Opposite divided by adjacent. So opposite is 20. Let me write here. Opposite is 20. This much is 20 minus 0. Adjacent is 2. 2 minus 0. So that is your acceleration. So therefore, what is acceleration? 20 by 2. 20 by 2 will come 10 meter per second square. 10 meter per second square. Okay. What about here? At t equal to 4 seconds. This is first part. Okay, first part. Second part. Anybody? What will be acceleration here? So what I should do? To find the acceleration at 4 seconds, I should go to the graph and draw a tangent. If I draw the tangent, how it is? The tangent is parallel to your time axis, right? So theta is 0. So at t equal to 4 seconds, your slope is 0. If slope of VT graph is 0, it means what? Acceleration is 0. Everybody understood? So just you need to find the slope. Okay. So you have to be careful at which point they are asking. Okay, so now students, this remaining part will be very, very important. I want all of you to concentrate for board exam also and for entrance exam also. Okay, so look carefully. The topic is derivation of kinematic equations. Derivation of kinematic equations. So there are three, derivation of kinematic equation. Okay, today I have not put the board properly. So derivation of kinematic equations, there are three kinematic equations, we have to derive them. Okay, so the first thing is, listen carefully. First equation that we have to derive. Okay, there are two ways to derive. One is graphically and one is by using calculus. When I say calculus, don't get scared. Calculus matlab using differentiation and integration. Anyone they can ask. If they ask calculus method and you do graphically, you will get zero. So if they ask calculus method, you have to use differentiation integration. If they say graphical method, you have to do this way. So first we will do using graph, or in bracket let me write graphically first we will do. Okay, so first you have to derive this equation V equal to U plus A. If this comes, it will come for just 3 marks. Now what is the most important assumption under this topic? The most important assumption is this. the acceleration of the moving body is taken to be constant.
So please remember what is constant in order to use these equations. Whenever I'm going to use these equations, whenever we are going, I've not muted. I thought I muted already. Oh yeah, some of them are chatting. Okay. So look here. Whenever we are going to use these equations, another two equations, one thing is very important. You can use these equations only when acceleration is constant. If it is not constant, we have to apply different technique, which I will teach you later. Don't worry. But all these equations can be used. These kinematic equations, which I'm going to derive today, we are going to use only when acceleration is constant. So if acceleration is not constant, never think of using these three formulas, which I'm going to derive.
So acceleration of the moving body is taken to be constant. So let us say A is constant. So now with A is constant, let us draw VT graph. Okay.
So since acceleration is constant, what is slope of VT graph? Be careful with what question I'm asking, VT graph or XT graph? Slope of VT graph is acceleration, right? No, I'm asking what quantity is slope of VT graph? Slope of VT graph is acceleration. Here what they told, acceleration is what? Constant. So that means slope should be constant. Slope constant means tan theta should be constant. So theta should be constant, not zero. If theta was zero, then your acceleration will be zero only. I'm saying acceleration is constant. If acceleration is constant, the slope of VT graph should be constant. How should I draw a line which has constant slope without taking zero? Straight line. So it should be something like this, right? This is your slant. Yeah, slant word is the right word.
So it will be slant. So this is your VT graph. Okay, so this is your VT graph.
Now, I did not start from origin. Since I did not start from origin, it means at time t equal to zero, let it have velocity equal to u. Let the velocity be equal to u. U is also called what velocity? Since it is at time zero, what velocity I can also call it? Initial velocity. So I can also call it initial velocity. Initial velocity. Okay. Which point it will be? This point, right? At time zero, na? So this time should be zero means here. So this is your initial velocity. Okay. This much is your initial velocity. Okay. From zero to here. This is your initial velocity. This, see, this coordinate is for velocity. So at t zero means origin. So at t zero, your y coordinate, which is velocity, is u. And at time t, velocity will be same or different? Velocity will be same or different? After some time, velocity will be same or different? Different. Why they will be different? Because there is acceleration. There is a constant acceleration. So velocity will change.
So let us write V.
Let us write V. That is also called final velocity.
But when I say final, it just means after time t. Where will be this in the graph? So this is at time zero. After some time, let's say here, what is the velocity? How to find the y coordinate? I hope everybody knows, right? So this is your v.
Okay, graph, you are understanding. This is the initial velocity. This is the final velocity. This axis is for velocity, remember. This axis is for time. So when time is zero, velocity is u. After t time, velocity is v. Okay. Now, I want to calculate, I want to derive the first formula, right? V equal to u plus a t.
So look here, we know that slope of vt graph is nothing but acceleration.
And mathematically, how we write slope?
Tan theta.
Right? Tan theta we write. And what is tan theta here? This angle.
This angle.
Because it is constant, no? So at any point you draw the tangent, it doesn't matter. Since acceleration is constant, at every point if you draw tangent, it will be this line only. So we need to calculate this tan theta. Everybody understood?
Now let us give some names to this. Let us call this O, this point A, this point B, this point C, this point D.
So this A, B, C, D are just I am using to denote the points.
Denote the points.
O I am using for origin.
This point I am writing A. This point I am writing B. This point I am writing C. This point I am writing D.
Now, in first you tell me in letters,
what is tan theta in this diagram?
First you write in terms of these points. Tan theta should be what? Opposite by adjacent.
So opposite is BC, adjacent is AC. That should be your A.
Right? That should be your A.
Now, what is BC? Let us check what is BC. BC is this. And that is same as this, right? This distance. This is same as this. And that distance will be this V minus this U. Yes or no? In a scale, if this number is 10, this number is 2, then this gap is how much?
This gap is how much?
8.
That is the meaning of scale. Y-axis, X-axis are like scale only, students.
So this gap will be V minus U. So BC is V minus U. AC will be same as OD. OD will be what? T minus 0. You can write T also, no problem. Equal to A. So V minus U divided by T will be A. Cross multiply. V minus U will be AT. So V will be equal to U plus AT.
So this much if you do, you will get 3 marks. This is your VT graph. And I hope all of you remember why the graph looks like this. Because the acceleration is constant. Since acceleration is constant, slope should be constant. Slope matlab tan theta should be constant. And for tan theta to be constant, the graph should be slant and it should be straight.
If your graph is like this,
then your slope is changing or constant? Here the slope is changing or constant?
Here the slope is changing, see? If you draw tangent.
So here slope is changing. So we will not apply this equation when acceleration is changing. We will apply this equation only when acceleration is constant. Finished? With the graph you have to write, okay students?
Okay. Let us call this equation one. Okay. Or this one you can call equation.
This one you can write equation one.
So this is your first kinematic equation. The second kinematic equation that we want to derive is S equal to ut plus half at square.
This is the second equation we have to derive. S is called displacement. Displacement. U is, you know already, initial velocity. A is acceleration, which is taken to be constant in this derivation. And t is the time taken.
Now, this derivation will come for 5 marks.
So, when they will ask this derivation, students, listen carefully. If they ask this derivation, you have to do this also. You have to do this also. Please remember. Are you understanding what I'm saying? If they ask this, you have to do this also. I will tell you why we need to do this also, but we have to do this also.
After doing this, now,
I hope everybody remembers I have taught to you in the previous classes
that displacement is area under VT graph. Those who remember, very good.
Those who have forgotten, please check the previous notes or videos. I hope you are writing the notes. So this I have already told you, yes or no? Displacement is nothing but area under VT graph. Okay. So we need to find the displacement.
We need to find the displacement from this graph. Okay. So let us start. We know that displacement is area under VT graph. Okay.
See, two things are very important whenever graphs are given. One is slope. Slope means dy by dx. And second thing is area. Area means integration. Okay.
And integration of velocity time is displacement.
So please check the notes of the previous classes. You will remember.
So since the graph is like this, this is the graph. We need to calculate area under this graph. Between what and what? 0 to t.
Same graph. Because acceleration is constant. No, Sumukha.
So same graph only. Between 0 to t I want, because this is what? Formula for what?
Displacement when time taken is t. Time taken is t matlab from 0 to t.
So from 0 to t we need to calculate this area. This area.
Understood or not? So this is the area which will give you the displacement. So now this area is area of what?
This shape is what kind of shape?
It's a trapezium. Okay, so those who know the area of trapezium, you can use that formula. But the way I will do is like this.
I will write this area as area of rectangle, area of rectangle OACB plus area of triangle ABC.
Okay, so this is how we are going to do. Okay,
first we will add this rectangle with this triangle. Then what is area of rectangle?
Length into breadth.
So here this is your length OD and breadth is your OA. You can also write CD and AC, that is your wish. Whether you write AC or OD, that is your wish. Plus,
area of triangle, I hope everybody knows,
half into base. For this triangle, base is AC, height is BC.
So first, students, you have to write in terms of these letters, in terms of these points you have to write. That is called derivation. No, directly if you write. See, some of you are very smart, I know. Directly you can do it. But for getting full marks, we have to first write in terms of these points. Once we write in these terms of the points, now we will put
the quantities which are important. So OD, what is OD? Tell me OD. OD, T. OA, OA, U, right? U minus zero, OA. OA is U minus zero, is OA. Plus half, AC. AC is nothing but OD only. AC and OD are same, so this T only. And BC, BC is V minus U. Equation 2. Okay, fine. Same graph you can use. No need to draw another graph. But if they ask this equation, then they want displacement. Therefore, you have to calculate area under VT graph, not slope. Slope of velocity time graph is acceleration. Area under velocity time graph is displacement. Those things you have to remember. Now we are going to use first equation here. So using the first equation, what was the first equation that I derived? V equal to U plus AT. Yes or no? Therefore, I can write V minus U equals to what here? V minus U will be what? AT. So I'm going to substitute V minus U here. Okay. So using equation 1, we have V minus U equal to AT. So putting in equation 2. What will you get? S equal to TU, I can write UT also, plus half T, and V minus U is nothing but AT. So this finally I can write UT plus half AT square. Yes or no? Everybody understood the derivation? Graph should be very neatly drawn in exam. Not like the way I am doing. Okay. And now I think you understood why you have to derive the first equation also. Because you need to use this. You have to substitute for this. Directly if they substitute, 2 marks they will cut. So first you have to derive equation 1, then use in equation 2. Okay, done. Okay, so now the third kinematic equation is V square minus U square equals to 2AS. If you see the formulas, the first equation, what this equation says? This equation says if you are moving right now with velocity U, right now, after time t, remember, okay, after, then your velocity will be V. So the connection between this final velocity and initial velocity is given in terms of time taken. So this is the first equation. Second equation is if you want to know this displacement, how much displacement it has moved from here to here. So second equation is to find the displacement if you know the time taken, because the formula is S equal to UT plus half AT square. Third equation is when you know the initial velocity, when you know the final velocity, but you don't know the time taken. Okay, but you know the distance covered. Then to find acceleration or any one of the quantity. How many quantities are there? See, 1, 2, 3, 4. So out of these 4, any one can be asked. Any one can be asked. But this will be used when time is not given. If distance covered is given. Okay, displacement is given. Now, I want all of you to try this at home, okay? I will do this, don't worry. I'm asking you another one. See, we have derived this equation, right? We have derived this equation. we have also derived this equation. Now tell me what is common between these two, which variable is common? Listen to my question carefully. I said which variable is common? Everybody agrees? So time is common here, t is common. So what you can do, what you can do is, look here, find time from here, find t from here, find t from here, then you substitute here, then you substitute here. Okay, find t from here, substitute here. Solpa, you have to solve. After solving, you will see, you will get this. You have to get this only. What will you get? Okay, but that is not the way we will do for board exam. We will do the way NCERT has done. Okay, but this is also another way you can do. And I want you to try this one. But for your board exam, this is how you should do. Look here. Look carefully. Average velocity . What is the definition of average velocity? If you know displacement, if you know time taken, if displacement is s, time taken is t, then it is s by t, because I wrote average velocity, right? So average velocity is displacement by time taken. Time taken is t here. Why, sir? Because I started from 0 to t. Don't tell me, sir, normally we write t2 minus t1. Yes, we can write, but here I started from time 0. So time 0 to time t, time taken will be what? T. Displacement I am writing s. Okay, students? Okay. So this is one of the equation we know. Okay. This is your third equation, no? Okay, let us write it separately, one equation. Also, average velocity can also be written as, in this time, what was the initial velocity in this time? In time t, what was the initial velocity? No. Hey, initial velocity, who's saying zero? Initial velocity was u. Final velocity was v. Yes or no? Final velocity was v. So I can write average velocity v plus u divided by 2 also. Okay, v plus u divided by 2. Initial velocity plus final velocity divided by 2. That can be written as your average velocity also. It is like asking average of 5 and 7. How to find average of 5 and 7? 5 plus 7 divided by 2. So once we know these two, once we know these two, what we will do? From 1 and 2, both are giving the same side, left side is same, both are average velocity. So I can write v plus u divided by 2 is equal to displacement by time. Now cross multiply. If you cross multiply, you will get v plus u into t equals to 2s. Equation 3. Okay, now we are going to substitute t from the first equation, the first kinematic equation. So, from the first equation, we know v equal to u plus at. So, I can bring u this side, v minus u will be at. Therefore, t will be what? V minus u divided by a. Correct? No, v minus u divided by a. So I'll put this t here. So putting t in equation 3. Putting t in equation 3. What will we get? Please keep writing. Okay, keep writing. So this is v plus u. In place of t, what I can write? V minus u divided by a equals to 2s. Till here, everything is fine. Let us go a little slow, no problem. Okay. So then you can use the formula a plus b, a minus b. So I hope everyone knows that formula.
Okay.
A plus B, A minus B formula is A square minus B square. So this I can write B square minus U square divided by this A is there equal to 2S. Then you simply cross multiply. So B square minus U square will be 2AS. So this is your third kinematic equation. This way it is easier to do. The way I taught to you, that also you can do, but that will be very lengthy. You will have to derive first equation, then you have to derive second equation, then you have to substitute T. It will take a lot of time. This is more easy. Find average velocity using two concepts. One is definition, displacement by time. One is by using the idea that if initial velocity is u, final velocity is v in time t, then average velocity you can write u plus v divided by 2. Yeah, you will get marks. If the teacher is somebody who does not concentrate on NCERT only, then you will get marks. But sometimes I have seen some teacher, no, they will tell, "Aray, why you did not write according to NCERT like that?" They will tell. So then it depends on your luck also. For board exam, better to stick to NCERT method. If I correct, I will give marks. I may give you one mark extra actually for writing so much. Okay, done. This is understood, right, everybody? Okay, now look here. How to use these equations? Now look here. Derivation was very easy, I know. All of you understood aram se. But while using these equations to solve problems, that is where you people will get lot of confusion. Sir, which formula to use? Sir, we are getting confused like that. So now I'm going to tell you properly how we are going to use these formulas, okay, and when we are going to use these formulas. And these three formulas should be on your fingertips. Anytime somebody will ask, pata pata, you should say. That doesn't mean you write down and go in exam. It means you have to remember them. 100% you should know. Okay, so S equal to ut plus half at square, V equal to u plus at, V square minus u square equals to 2as. By the way, for this third derivation, I have to derive first one or not? I should derive first one or not? I have to derive. Okay, that's why graphical method it is. Okay. So now look carefully. How to use the equation? Okay, how to use the equation? Kinematic equation. This is just separately I'm doing from my side. First thing is to check if acceleration is constant or not. So you have to read the question and you have to check whether acceleration is constant or not. Matlab, if acceleration is given like 5 m/s², then will you use these equations or you will not use? If acceleration is given like this, will you use or will you not use? Who is saying no? 5 matlab constant, no. So if acceleration is given as 5, numbers are constant, students, numbers are constant. So if acceleration is given as 5, 10, 9.8, I don't care. If it is given as a number, or if they say in the question, acceleration should be taken to be constant, then only I am going to read. So first thing is to check this. Okay. But suppose they may write acceleration is 5t. Now will you use or not? Now you cannot use, because now acceleration has been given in the form of a function. So now acceleration is given as a function of time. Function of time matlab what? With time, acceleration is changing. Then you cannot think of these three equations. Okay? Fine. Once you have understood this, the second thing is to know the path. Okay, to know the path. So suppose the path is like this. Okay, the particle is going like this and then coming back like this. Let's say. So this is the path. By the way, this is 1D motion. Okay, 1D motion. Whatever we have derived is for one dimension. Now look carefully. If the particle is moving in one dimension, then there are two possibilities. It can either go this way or come back. That's it. Okay. So the first thing is you have to read the question and decide which one is your initial point. So if I choose this as initial, then here you have to think this is time zero, and this is your final t. Then whatever velocity it has here, that will be what in my equations, whatever I've used. That will be my u. So whatever velocity the particle has, that will be u here. And if this is your final point, now who will decide the final point? You will decide depending on the question. Later we will solve more question. Don't worry, you will get idea. But you will have to decide. So if this is your final time, if this point is your final time, whatever velocity it has here, that is your v. That is your v. Okay. And s is what s. S is displacement, and displacement how do you draw? From initial to final, that is your displacement. Okay, and acceleration can be either here or it can be here. Remember, so that you have to read the question and decide. So acceleration can be either here or it can be here. Okay, so that you have to decide depending on the question. So this is the main thing to understand: what is u, what is v, what is displacement, what is the meaning of t here. T here is the time taken from the initial to the final. Okay, one problem if we solve, we will get a very good idea. But I think before we start solving the problem, we should solve. Then only idea will come. Okay. So you only try, I will also do it. Extra question only. So a car moves with, last question for today, a car moves with velocity 10 meter per second east. A car moves with velocity 10 meter per second east. It has an acceleration 2 meter per second square west. It has an acceleration 2 meter per second square west. Find the time taken for the car to stop. Find the time taken for the car to stop. Also, the distance, or let me write displacement, during this interval. Okay, so when I read this question, first thing what I check, what is the acceleration? 2 meter per second square. It is constant, so I can, yes, I can use. Now mentally I will draw a picture. So car is there, so you can draw some car, right? It is moving with velocity 10 meter per second east. So east, let us take this side. So it is moving with some velocity 2 meter per second. That will be what, u, because this is my time zero. This is my time zero. Understood? Starting time. Now it has an acceleration 2 meter per second square west, they are saying. So west matlab where, I should say same direction or opposite direction? Opposite. So acceleration will be this side. So while substituting, you have to write, initial velocity is 10 students. Initial velocity is 10 actually, see, 10 meter per second. Acceleration while writing, you cannot write 2, remember, because it is in opposite direction. So minus 2 you have to write. So minus means it is in this direction. Okay, and then I will draw some, the car will continue and it travels some distance And here what should happen, they told, it should stop. So if it stops means here when it reaches final velocity should be zero. So like this, a picture should be there in your mind, a picture. Now check what are the quantities you know. What are the quantities you know? Initial velocity you know. Final velocity is zero. That also you know. Zero matlab you know, no? Zero it is. Acceleration you know. Displacement do you know? Displacement we don't know. Time taken we don't know. So which equation I should use to first find the time taken? To find the time taken, which equation I should use? Time taken from here to here will be what? This is after t time, t minus zero. So how to find time taken? Though can I think of this formula? Should I think of this formula? No, because I don't know displacement. So you should not think of this formula because you don't know displacement. Should I think of this formula? What, sir? What nonsense you are saying, sir? This formula doesn't have time only. This formula doesn't have time only. So this is the way you have to think slowly. Okay, this is easy question, I know, but later when we will do more difficult question, thinking will be same only. So it is very clear I have to use this formula. So using, now please remember v, u and a, these are vector quantities. Right now I am not putting bar because we are doing in one dimension. In one dimension, no need to put vector. This side plus, this side minus, you think. That's it. So final velocity is zero. Initial velocity is 10. Acceleration is minus 2. Time taken is t. So this will become 0 equal to 10 minus 2t. Minus 2t will come this side. That will be 10, so t will be 5 seconds. Correct? Okay. Once I know time is 5 seconds, now I need to know displacement. Now for displacement, you have two options. See, so nice life, two options you have. You can use s equal to ut also. Why I can use this? Because you know time. And you can also use this also. You can use this also because you know u also, v also. So anyone you can use. That is your choice. So let me use this. Initial velocity was 10. No. Now I know time taken is 5 seconds. Acceleration is minus 2. Be careful about the sign. Time taken is 5. Right? So what is the displacement finally, students? 10 into 5 is 50, plus minus is minus, 2 to cancel, 25. So displacement is 25 meters. See, displacement came positive or negative? It came positive or negative? Positive. That means the car will be moving this way only. Displacement will be this way only. Acceleration was this way, I know. Acceleration was this way. But car will still move this way because already it has initial velocity. And how much time it took to stop? 5 seconds. Okay. Now let us say, suppose by mistake you wrote here, you did not write minus 2. Suppose you did not write minus 2 by mistake. Acceleration you saw 2 and directly you wrote 2 here. Then what answer will you get? If by mistake you write 2 here, how much time taken it will be? It will be minus 5. That will be stupid answer. Time taken is minus 5 means what? You started now, but you reach 5 seconds before. How it is possible? If I start now, I will not reach yesterday. No, I will not reach yesterday there. So time taken cannot be negative. At least in Newtonian physics, time taken cannot be negative. Understood or not? So be careful about not to put here plus. That's why you have to read the question properly. Yes, Stalin, it could be time travel, but that doesn't happen in this case. So thank you. Any doubt is there, you can discuss with me. That is for your understanding, Tapasum. That is for your understanding. Yes, yes, you can use that also. Tapasum, you can use that equation also.